Thank you.
Gentlemen, this next question, I think we're going to start with you, Brad. Is, in your opinion, the current Secretary of State, Kemp, what would you say that has been his most positive action in the Secretary of State's office during his tenure? And would you seek to emulate his leadership style or take things in a different direction?
I believe that Secretary Kemp's home run was the SEC primary. That put us on the map. We're finally into play, and it was important, you know, what Georgian voters did in the presidential campaign. So I think that was a home run. Secretary Kemp is a man of honor. He's a good family man, and I respect that. I've been very patrician for over 40 years now. And he's just a really nice person, a great guy. I think the SEC primary is the one that really hit out.
This is that violent agreement again. I would definitely say the SEC primary is something that has allowed Georgia to have a bigger say in the presidential election. That's the importance of it, by the way. It's not just moving the primary around. It's the idea that the presidential candidates have to first come to the state of Georgia so that they can hear from our residents, from our citizens. And what that does, being a statewide candidate, much smaller scale. But when you hear from residents, when you hear constituents, it does alter how you see things. It kind of gives you a lens in which to look through the rest of the race from. So I think that is important. Another thing that is important, we kind of touched on that a moment ago, is I think it's incredibly important, and this is nothing against Kennesaw State, but the Secretary of State is responsible for the security of our voter information, which means that that information needs to be directly under his supervision and under his control and not in a third party. And I think it's important to bring that inside, and we're starting to do that now. And I think that's going to be an excellent decision by Secretary Kemp as well. And I think in terms of, you know, the second part of that question was about leadership style. While I know Brian Kemp, I don't know that I'm qualified to comment on his leadership style. But I will say, I believe that there's two sides of the coin again. There's those direct responsibilities, corporations, elections, securities, licensing. But there's opportunity. They say 159, we have 159 counties. They say 85 of those 159 counties are projected to lose both jobs and population by the year 2030, in just 12 years. And so I think it's imperative that we look beyond those direct responsibilities and focus on growing what Georgia does best, agriculture, technology, and logistics.
Well, one of the things that I have grown to respect most about Brian Kemp as I've been campaigning across the state is I have found, as I travel to communities across this state, that Brian Kemp has spent years developing relationships with local leaders. He will be on his way to an event or doing something with his job as Secretary of State, and he'll just stop by and visit with the mayor or pop in and see the leader of the Chamber of Commerce or call the county commissioner on the phone. He's been doing that for years. And as a result, a lot of these folks, you know, whether they vote for him or not, they respect him. And I think that's important. As I've been in politics, I have discovered that relationships are crucially important. If you're going to get anything done, people have to trust you and respect you. And I think that's why Brian Kemp has been able to get some stuff done. He's built those relationships and built that trust. And so I would try to emulate that. It's hard work. But I think that I would try to emulate that and do that in the office. You know, for management style, I'm a different person. I'm going to manage the office differently than he does, just because we're different people. And I have my style of management, he has his. And not that anyone is right or wrong, but mine is different, and we'll implement that when I'm Secretary of State. Great question. Thank you.
I would say one of Secretary Kemp's greatest accomplishments was his development of the Student Ambassadors Program to engage young people in the elections process. And I'd certainly like to build on that and look for ways to reward young people and recognize young people who are engaging in the civic culture that we certainly want people to grow up with. We want them to be participants in the political process, not just voters, but people who think critically about public policy issues, engage in those debates. That's vitally important to a vibrant democracy. In terms of management style, I agree with some of the comments made earlier. I think being accessible is incredibly important. And that's something that I would like to do, that I think Secretary Kemp has done a tremendous job doing in terms of keeping a pulse on particularly local elections officials around the state and getting feedback from them on what's happening in their communities. I think one way that I might be a little bit different is in looking for a big solution to a problem by building a very large grand coalition. In this case, what I'm talking about is adequately funding the licensing division of the Secretary of State's office. We can do that by passing a constitutional amendment to dedicate licensing fees, so the fees that are paid for those services actually go to the service provider. And I think the way to do that is to reach out to all of the associations that represent over 100 different licensed professions and bring them together. And I have experience doing that. That's what we did with the ethics reform legislation. We took on big entrenched interests, even some establishment leaders within my own party, to pass a really important public policy initiative to increase public confidence in government by ending unlimited gifts from lobbyists to members of the legislature. We can do the same thing with dedicating those licensing fees and finally providing the adequate level of service folks.